honor to God. I have to say so.
All right.
Because I would make my mother. I can't talk too much in the American kind of horse. But I don't have so many good days today. My mother and my family. And that's why I did what I did.
All right.
It wasn't a burden or anything like that. It was something that I could do no more. Mm-hmm. I did everything I could do. The worst thing I could, to me, that I could ever do in life, when I had to put my mother to come and left home.
Yes, it was.
Yeah. You know, and they caught it. My mother was coming over and everything. But then, I went to a family reunion last week, and the preacher, she told me, she came up because she knew she was close to the family, she understood everything that was going on. And she told me, she said, you know what, your mother is tired, she's ready to go home. But she's not going to go home, because she don't want to leave you.
Mm-hmm.
And until she know that you're going to be all right, then she'll go home. This was on Saturday at the Davenport Family Unit in Williamsburg. Sunday, I received a telephone call from the governor's home telling me that she had gotten worse and they wanted to put on oxygen and wanted to get my approval. And I told him, okay, I'll be right over. And so I went over and I sat with her until it was like 9:30 that night. I was talking to the doctor and I asked him, how long do you think she's going to be on that oxygen? I didn't like the way she looked. I didn't look like she was going through pain. He said, no, she's not going through pain or anything. And I said, but how long is she going to be on that oxygen? And he said, probably for the rest of her life. He said, I've been cursed with morphine. And so she's comfortable. She's not in the pain or anything like that. Say, you see, you stay here as long as you want to stay here with her. But then, just like I did with my father, when he got a long time, I got home from Korea. Then he passed 3 days after I got home. So once I got home, he was at ease. It was like, you know, I was all right. And so he went on home. Sunday night, I went home. I said, I'll be back tomorrow morning. And he said, okay. At 6:15 Monday morning, that's when I got the call. Then my mother had passed. And so I said to myself, yeah, you know, she's going to be high. I want to go in the casket is a picture of my mother and my father together. But I'm going to be okay. I'm going to have plans and everything like that. And I know probably tomorrow, a couple of days, some of my classmates will be laughing at me.
church that I
Yes.
That's right.
That's so much.
They, you know, they love me.
And amen. I love them.
Amen. Nothing they would do for me.
That's right.
We had Wednesday at our church.
As we said.
We had Wednesday. That's a big day at our church. And they came here just to be with me. Chairman and I work together. We don't argue. You know, we might have disagreements.
Yes.
But we don't argue.
Amen. We chairman, and I enjoy working for him.
All right.
But anyway, I'll talk about my mother. I am not the oldest, but I am next to the oldest. But Frankie took over, and everybody thinks Frankie is the oldest. Mother, because I made up in my mind, I talked over to my wife. I said, if anything go wrong with mother, I said, mother had to come here with me. That's in my mind. It was okay with my wife. I said, mother had to come. I'm going to bring her to live with me. And I often called Frankie many times. I said, Frankie, you want me to come home? No, I got everything. I'll call him. Next week I'll call him. Frankie, you need me to come home? No, everything is all right. And Frankie did a, I'm telling you,
fantastic.
Frankie did a wonderful job. Sister and my two sisters, my brothers, they were in New Jersey. My mom caught me in the backyard and she said, I got five children. Hey, what she said. Mother said, I got five children. I was young then. And I worry about you more than I worry about you. Florida. And mother told us I'm tired, I ain't gonna make it.
vacation every year. That's where day-to-day that you travel. So church, I want to say, may God bless each and every one of you all. God bless you. I thank you all for coming here. Amen. Thanks for your love.